Hello.
And welcome to the Raleigh County Schools review of the Cardiac Emergency Response Plan. I'm Angie Foster, Director of Health Services for Raleigh County Schools.
And I'm Chad Cox, Academy Careers and Technology Instructor for Emergency Management and Firefighting, as well as the Emergency Medical Technician Program.
Today we are here to discuss the new requirements enacted by the West Virginia Legislature in the last legislative session. West Virginia State Code 18-5-22E states that in the beginning of the school year 2024-2025, that the Board of Education will develop a cardiac emergency response plan, otherwise known as CERP, that addresses use of the school cardiac plan and AED for cardiac arrest and similar life-threatening emergencies while on school grounds. That can be in a school building or at an athletic event on the campus. The West Virginia Code also states that prior to the start of each athletic season, a school shall hold an informational meeting, which we are doing here today, for students, parents, guardians, to review the plan. And this plan will also be posted as required on the school's website. The actual code requirements is as follows. The form has to be completed once you attend the meeting. And this form is called the Athlete's Acknowledgement Notice. And according to the code, all student athletes and their parents or guardians are required to attend an informational meeting each school year. So we will have to do this starting this year and every year after. On the notice, you will find that there's a space for you to fill out the student's name, student signature, parent name, parent signature, and you will need to place on this form any sport that your child plans to try out for this school year. By doing so, it will eliminate the need for you to attend additional meetings during the year. If you have children in other schools, every school in the county will be holding these informational meetings. So if you have a child in elementary school that plays basketball and you have a child in middle school that plays a sport and high school that plays a sport, all the schools will have the meetings, but you will need to make sure that your child attends these meetings with you and that this form is completed so that we fulfill the requirements of the state law.
The cardiac emergency response team in Raleigh County Schools is called the Medical Response Team. This CERP document provides direction and guidance for responding to any cardiac event or cardiac arrest in a school building or at an athletic event.
The Cardiac Emergency Response Plan provides direction and guidelines for responding to a sudden cardiac arrest on the school campus. The Raleigh County CERP includes the following information. As Mr. Cox had said, the Cardiac Emergency Response Team in Raleigh County Schools is called the Medical Response Team. We have a medical response team that is designated for each of our school buildings. The school principal building administrator works with the school nurse and individuals in the building who have had CPR and AED training are designated on those teams. For athletics, it's a little bit different. For athletics, we have coaches and athletic trainers and staff who are at the events who have been trained in AED use and CPR.
It's important to know the storage of the AEDs in the facilities are going to be in an unlocked cabinet at a designated area. Be sure that you know where that area is at your facility. There is at least one AED in every facility of Raleigh County Schools. Whereas for athletic events, the AED is transported with the coach or athletic trainer, and it is in a case, which we'll talk about in just a few minutes. In Raleigh County Schools, we have the Cardiac Science AED, as well as the Phillips Heart Start AED. The Phillips Heart Start AED is most commonly found with the athletic trainer or the coach for athletic events.
Raleigh County Schools has developed a maintenance plan for all AEDs that includes building AEDs and athletic AEDs. The AEDs are checked daily, monthly, and yearly so that we can maintain, make sure that the maintenance and requirements are in place for safe and proper use in the county. Following the use of an AED, Raleigh County Schools has a post-use procedure protocol that we use. The AED will be given to the school nurse, and the school nurse will be responsible for cleaning the AED and restocking any supplies that were used during the event and putting the AED back out for use.
There will be a video presented shortly that will demonstrate the use of both the Cardiac Science AED as well as the Philips Heart Start AED. Although the videos are very thorough, we wanted to make sure that we emphasized that both AEDs come in cases. And these cases will be removed before utilizing the AED. Once the case has been removed, when you open the AED, it will turn itself on and voice prompts will be provided for you to follow.
Stay calm. Follow these instructions.
With each AED, there'll be a ready kit. It may be red in color, or it may be black. Each kit contains supplies that you might utilize during a cardiac arrest or a cardiac emergency. Those supplies consist of proper personal protection equipment, such as a pocket mask with a one-way valve, gloves for your hands, some scissors that you can use for removing any clothing that might be in the way of proper CPR or AED usage, and a razor to remove any excess hair in the area of the pads placement. As per state code, our local EMS, fire departments, and Office of Emergency Services will be provided with a copy of our cardiac emergency response plan.
Annually, and after any time that we would use the AED, the plan will be reviewed and evaluated, and any changes that are necessary would be implemented during that time. Please make sure that you received a copy of this cardiac emergency response plan that was developed for Raleigh County for use during school hours as well as after hours and on the campus.
So we have here a simple algorithm for adult basic life support, or CPR, and we will watch a video that will demonstrate that so that you have a better understanding.
If you see a teen or adult suddenly collapse, it's important to act fast. Helping to save a life is easier than you might think. Just start hands-only CPR. The first step is to send someone to call 911 or call 911 yourself. Then get directly over the victim. Put the heel of one hand in the center of the chest, then put your other hand on top of the first. Then push hard and fast in the center of the chest until help arrives. It's important to push, giving 100 to 120 compressions per minute, which is about the same tempo as the song Stayin' Alive. Let's hope you never have to use hands-only CPR. But if you see a teen or adult suddenly collapse, don't be afraid to try it. Remember, call 911, then push hard and fast in the center of the chest until help arrives. Your actions can help save a life.
As mentioned earlier, Raleigh County School System uses two different kinds of AEDs, one being the Cardiac Science, the other one is the Philips Heart Start. Both of these AEDs will be demonstrated in a video.
A save station houses an automated external defibrillator, or AED, that is for anyone to use. In the event of an emergency, it's important we all understand what to do until medical help arrives, because every second matters.
Zach, are you okay? Zach, can you hear me? Zach. Can you go call 911, tell them we have an unconscious male, and report back to me once you're done?
Yes.
Perfect, thank you. Kate, can you go grab the AED from the save station? Do you know where it is?
Yes.
Bring it back to me once you get it.
Unusual breathing, or gasping, is common during sudden cardiac arrest. This is called agonal breathing. If someone is not breathing normally, you need to begin CPR immediately.
Okay.
Stay calm. Follow these instructions. Make sure emergency services are called now. Begin by exposing patient's bare chest. Remove or cut clothing if needed. When patient's chest is bare, remove the white square package from lid of AED. Tear open white package across dotted line and remove pads. Peel one of the white pads completely from blue plastic. Firmly place the pad on patient's bare chest, exactly as shown on pads. Do not touch the patient, analyzing heart rhythm. Shock advised.
Stand clear.
Press red flashing button to deliver shock. Shock delivered. It is now safe to touch the patient. Give patient 30 rapid compressions and 2 breaths. Press, 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 press. Stop CPR. Do not touch the patient. Analyzing heart rhythm. Shock not advised.
He's breathing.
It is now safe to touch the patient.
Zach, it's okay. Help's on the way.
It's gonna be okay. 911's called.
Zach, you're okay.
Begin by removing all clothing from the patient's chest. Cut clothing if needed. When patient's chest is bare, remove protective cover and take out white adhesive pads. Look carefully at the pictures on the white adhesive pads. Peel one pad from the yellow plastic liner. Place pad exactly as shown in the picture. Press firmly to patient's bare skin. Peel the second pad from the yellow plastic liner. No one should touch the patient. Analyzing. Shock advised. Stay clear of patient. Press the flashing orange
button. Stand clear. All clear? Shocking now.
Shock delivered. It is safe to touch the patient. Begin CPR. For help with CPR, press the flashing blue button. Keep time with the beat. No one should touch the patient. Analyzing.
He's breathing.
Shock not advised.
Help's on the way, okay? I'm gonna roll you into the recovery position. Zach, you're okay.
How to use the Philips on-site AED on a child. Adult pads will be pre-installed in the AED. Check to see if you have child pads available. If child pads are not available, it is safe to use adult pads, but follow the video instructions for proper pad placement. Remove adult pads by releasing the lever at the top of the AED. Replace with the pediatric cartridge. Place one pad on the center of the chest between the nipples. Place the second pad in the center of the back between the shoulder blades. Continue to follow voice prompts until medical help arrives. Always be on the lookout for the nearest AED and don't be afraid to use it. Keep up with your CPR and AED skills. Together, we have the power to save a life.
We would like to review the warning signs and symptoms for students of all ages and risks associated with continuing to play or practice after experiencing the following symptoms. Fainting.
Seizures during exercise that's unexplained.
Shortness of breath.
Chest pains or palpitations.
Dizziness.
Feeling of a racing heart.
Or extreme fatigue. West Virginia Code 18-5-22E states that a student shall not be allowed to participate in an athletic activity if either of the following occurs. The student is known to have exhibited syncope or fainting at any time prior to or following an athletic activity and has not been evaluated and cleared to return to play after exhibiting syncope or fainting. Or the student experiences syncope or fainting while participating in or immediately following an athletic activity.
If the student is not allowed to participate or is removed from participation in an athletic activity, the student shall not be allowed to return to participation until they are evaluated and cleared for return in writing by any of the following: a physician, a certified nurse practitioner or clinical nurse specialist, or a licensed physician assistant.
This concludes our presentation today. Please be sure that you have completed the athletic acknowledgement notice, and be sure to give that to one of the staff members here at the meeting. Thank you for attending, and we hope you found this information beneficial.